body.
Think, what am I? And you look at this body and you see what it is. Bones and skin and flesh and blood. What are these things? Just parts of this world.
He died as he lived, with his heart purely and simply at peace. Later that morning, Ajaan Paññāvaḍḍho's body was placed in the main sala at Wat Pa Baan Taad, where monks and lay people came to pay their final respects in traditional Buddhist fashion. The following day, Ajaan Paññāvaḍḍho's body was placed in a suitably dignified casket. His body lay in state in the main sala at Wat Pa Baan Taad for the next 8 days awaiting cremation. On the morning of August the 27th, the day before the cremation, Ajaan Paññāvaḍḍho's casket was carried from the main sala to a large meeting hall adjacent to the funeral pyre.
What exists is not real, and what is real doesn't exist. Try thinking what'll it be when I die if I don't get through in this practice. Where are you going to be reborn? You don't know. I mean, I think that I've got to overcome this. These kilesas, dukkha. Saw a log of wood floating down the Ganges. He said to his followers, he said, that log will reach the ocean, provided it doesn't get snagged up by other sort of weeds and other things in the water, provided it doesn't sort of get caught on a sandbank, provided it doesn't go rotten and sink, and provided it's not taken by gods or men for use, if all this is okay, then in the end it'll float out into the ocean.
At 1 o'clock that afternoon, Ajahn Mahabua formally addressed the large crowd of Buddhist faithful, gathered in reverence to pay their final respects.
ไม่เคยได้ตำหนิติเตียนหรือดูด่าว่ากล่าวท่านเลยท่านมาอยู่กับเราหลวงตาบัวที่ล่ำลือนั่นแหละเพราะว่าล่ำลือว่าดุว่าดุแต่กับท่านปัญญาไม่เคยได้ดุเลย ท่านเป็นผู้ปฏิบัติดีปฏิบัติชอบเป็นรู้รักธรรมรักวินัยซึ่งเป็นองค์ศาสดาของพวกเราชาวพุทธทั้งหลายธรรมและวินัยก็ได้แก่ศีลและธรรมนั่นแหละเป็นศาสดาของพวกเราทั้งหลายแทนพระพุทธเจ้า
He extolling Ajahn Paññā for his exceptional wisdom and virtue. Monks then approached the funeral pyre to receive traditional offerings of cloth and to place ceremonial bunches of wooden flowers there as a final token of respect. Formally begin their cremation. Ajaan Paññāvaḍḍho's funeral ceremony was the largest event ever held at Wat Pa Baan Taad. An estimated 50,000 people attended to pay their final respects, including over 4,000 monks. The cremation pyre continued to burn late into the night. When the hot embers finally cooled down, the charred pieces of bone that survived the fire were collected to be distributed among the faithful as objects of worship. The extreme heat of the fire had caused the larger bone segments to break up, leaving many small, often porous fragments. Such bone fragments, often burned to an ashen white colour by the fire, are kept by Buddhists and treasured as relics. From beginning to end, Ajaan Paññāvaḍḍho's funeral marked a supremely graceful conclusion to the life and practice of a monk whose loving kindness and humility radiated softly from his presence to encompass the whole world of samsara.